Hey there everyone, my name is Hitesh and I make coding videos. And in today's coding video, I want to teach you how to build a SaaS, software as an application. A lot of time, a lot of people want to build SaaS products, and SaaS product doesn't need to be really, really complex. You don't need to build the Salesforce or an LMS application or something similar to that. You can build a really tiny application which can be useful for people, and in these days can be powered by AI, and you can really serve your customers well. And not only just customers, you can also build some utilities as well that can also serve as a free SaaS or as an open source SaaS or just as a project that, hey, this is my portfolio project or a showcase project that can help you to land up a job. The world of the software as a service really should be focused up now because the more you build the product which is being useful by somebody, that's where the whole magic comes up. And now there are even AIs which can help you to do so. So in today's video, we're going to go through with the application which we are going to build as a SaaS. But before that, I would love to show you a tweet which is going to even solidify what I really want to say in this one. First, let's see this, and then we're going to talk a little bit on that. So there was a recent tweet which actually got my attention and which says something like this, that, hey, Ian, it says $30,000 a month. Pretty good. It says that's how much you can make converting files from one format to another. Sounds unrealistic, but yeah, there's a lot of traffic on these websites where people want to convert from one file format to another. Some even are paid services, some are free services, which earns through the advertisement revenue. It's boring, it's evergreen problem, it's a simple solution, and it's run by a small team. It's a pretty decent money, it's a pretty good money that somebody can achieve. Now, here's my point. A lot of people believe that, hey, for the SaaS, we need to really fill up with a complex solution. No, you don't need. If you look at the Vercel, which is of course a complex and a big company, but it runs on top of AWS. If everybody knows AWS, nobody would use Vercel. But as you know, Vercel is a big company, a great company. It added a little solution on top of it, and now we have Vercel. Similar to this, you can build your solutions on top of some other AIs and other companies and can have a product of your own. And that's exactly what we'll be doing. We'll be taking the power of the AI, we'll be building up a solution and a really good solution which has a need. You can take this project further in your journey and can have it. Let me show you what this project is. And I am pretty sure you are going to absolutely love this. Let me just share the screen. And in a second, just there we go. So if I go ahead, and by the way, in case you haven't joined us yet on the Discord, go ahead and join us on the Discord. There are already more than 50,000 programmers who help each other out. So go ahead and join me on the Discord on hitesh.ai/discord and check out our courses at chaicode.com. More stuff is there. Now let me show you something really interesting. So apart from this, what we're going to build, let me first have a demo of this so that you can see what's happening there. So what we're building is this, which has a homepage, and you can see a video is being displayed. So anybody can see the video, and this is like our own YouTube, you can say that. You can upload as many, or anybody can upload any video, and that will be listed up here. More videos will come up, it will scroll down and have more videos. Now, apart from this, if I go ahead and click on social share or upload video, of course, they are protected. So we're gonna be saying that, hey, these are being protected. And once you actually go ahead and sign up, it sends you a verification code on your email. You have to fill up that code and then only you can log in. So I'm going to go ahead and sign in with my email address here. All right, so I'm signed in. I've signed up with my email address here and it redirects you back onto the homepage. Homepage is same for everyone. Logged in, non-logged in, doesn't really matter. Things actually start to happen once I go into this one, and let me go ahead and log in again. So let me just go ahead and log in. And there we go. And I'll enter my password. Hopefully this one is correct. Let's go ahead and check out the password. And yep, I'm already logged in. Probably I just need to refresh it. And there we go. I'm logged in. So yes, we can definitely manage the states and everything better. And we'll be doing that as well. But as you can see, there we go. We have just a name up here and my email address that shows up. We have the logout button as well. Very decent. We are using Clerk as a login system being authenticated there. In case you want to go more in depth of the authentication and login systems, I do have a separate playlist on Next.js, which uses absolutely raw MongoDB and Next.js to walk you through with the process. But in this one, this is a SaaS product, so we'll be using just as Clerk for our authentication. Now, here's the interesting part. I'll walk you through one by one. First of all, let's go into the social share. This is an image. You can just go ahead and upload an image. Let me go ahead and use this image or this image. This one seems good. And I'll open this up. As soon as you open this image, you can just go ahead and see that it displays the image into one by one, which is square format. And as you can see, this is a Cloudinary showcase, so we'll be utilizing a lot of Cloudinary and AI of the Cloudinary, not just the Cloudinary. So you can see this is one by one, this is a square image, and you can just go ahead and download this. Square images are for Instagram. But let's just say you want to have a cover image for Facebook. Yes, still a lot of people use Facebook. You can just provide them, hey, download this cover image. And this doesn't just retransform your image, it actually uses Cloudinary AI so that it's a context-aware resize of the image. It could have done the resize on the very top or could have done at the very bottom. This doesn't really make sense. People want more content to be there, more context to be there. So the photo is there, the text is there. Of course, photo is of highest importance and then the text is of more importance. So it actually transformed that's everything based on the AI. Apart from this, if you want to have Twitter header, so it goes ahead and transform that Twitter headers, different sizes. If you want to have Instagram portrait into 4x5, it goes and transforms that into that and takes care of the image. It knows that image is of highest context here. And there we go, your Instagram portrait is ready in 4x5. And you can just go ahead and transform it into more of such set. A Twitter post of 16:9, a ratio if you want to have that, it just goes ahead and does that. So this is a nice utility, and definitely you can add more of such transformation. It's a context-aware transformation. It's not just cropping the videos from any size, it's taking care. You can upload any image. The image, the user could be at the very right side here, and it will transform accordingly. It's all being done magically by the AI. Not only that, you have the option to upload the video. You can have the title, description, and just upload the video. Once you upload the video, on the homepage, we display all these videos. And the first important part is, content-aware preview. Now, you might have seen in the YouTube that when you hover onto any video, it starts to play that video. We're not going to just play the first second of the video. We have the AI capability to pick up the most important seconds or the frames of the video, and we'll be displaying those frames as preview in that video. So if you hover this up, the most important activity that's happening is going to be available for the preview. Not only that, we are also providing a compression service of the video, which is crazy good. As you can see, I have uploaded a 1.15 MB of the video, and we were able to do a 45% of the compression here. So if I go ahead and shrink this a tiny bit, there we go. And you can see, and now anybody can download the compressed video of 635 KB. There is not much of the quality loss. Barely you can see that on the screen, and we can have that. The more higher the video you are going to add, it sometimes does like 60% or 65% of the compression. And there we go. It's a really nice and fun project. You can just click on the download. It opens up onto a new tab, but you can just go ahead and use just the download or pop-up as well. However you want, you can just click up here and there we go, download button. You can just go ahead and download the videos as well. You can play the video entirely up here as well. There's so much more that we can do. Now, as of now, we're going to do only this much, but I hope you saw that building up these projects increase your knowledge, helps you with the idea about how the SaaS product is being built. And a lot of people need these kinds of services, transformations, changing of the photos. Not everybody is a techie, just like you and me, and a lot of people are there on the internet and they need services like this. So probably you can show them these services. You can earn via having the AdSense. You can earn via charging a small subscription and add a markup on top of the Cloudinary. There's so much more you can do. And Cloudinary even provides a lot of free credits as well. So I'm going to walk you through in this entire project that how you can use Cloudinary AI with so much more of the tech. We'll be using Zustand, we'll be using Next.js, we'll be using Daisy UI for this one, we'll be using Zod, we'll be using Clerk for authentication, and so much more of the logic that we'll be going through. So it's a really fun project. Go ahead, join me up in building up this project. I'm pretty sure you're excited about this, as I am very much. So let's go ahead, start the fresh project with the Next.js, and finish this up. The UI part is also very fancy, and it's very easy to build because we are using Daisy UI. And again, feel free to use Shad CN or any other UI as well. I just like to use different sets of the UI in different projects. So that's all for this one. Let's go ahead and catch up in the next video and start building this project.